2020 may have been the worst year, but it's been the most productive year I've ever lived.
The second quarantine began, I started working on my own animated short series, basically a knockoff of Phineas and Ferb, but it was a lot of good work. My friends and I built a Minecraft realm, and we had a lot of fun building things on there, so that took up a lot of my time. I had previously been inspired by many contemporary artists, such as Julie Moretti, and I've always wanted to create my own, like, large-scale contemporary piece. And this time gave me the time to do it, and I started a massive one in March. I created the world's most dangerous self-powered vehicle right around the time that I got my first puppy, and here's a little clip of him. Probably my greatest accomplishment during the whole summer was terraforming my entire backyard and building a massive garden. Being outside all day in the nature and really transforming the place really gave me a clear head and helped me get through. I planted dozens of different vegetable crops, and they kept growing more and more and more every day, looking bigger and more beautiful. And I went out every single day to harvest them and got huge harvests like this one. Then after watching a video of Centropic Agroforestry in Florida, I became obsessed with collecting rare tropical fruit trees. Every day I went out, bought plants, studied them, and began to turn my backyard into a living rainforest. This activity fueled most of my summer, and shaped into what I would consider one of the best summers I've ever had. Then this happened. Like most other internet travelers, this year I discovered Everywhere at the End of Time, and Leland Kirby and Ivan Seale's work. I was particularly inspired by An Empty Bliss and Stage 3 of Everywhere at the End of Time, and this just completely changed my life and the way I lived. Like most people, I did Everywhere at the End of Time in one shot, just straight through, and the whole time I was busy working on studying the trees and all the different biologies and stuff, so every time I heard any of the songs, which I frequently played from stage 1 through 3, it would just remind me of growing the trees, and that kind of built a culture and just a feeling around the summer. This artistically inspired me so much, and I even created my own oil painting version of Empty Bliss. This really inspired my art taste, and I began to immerse myself into the world of art. While working on these long projects, I learned how to make wine from my own homegrown Merlot grapes, and I learned how to make noodles and a lot of other kinds of food. Some of the notable foods I cooked were biang biang mian, rigatoni, a delicious steak, a massive oven-roasted tri-tip, a 20-course Korean barbecue meal with a ton of banchan, tacos, jintan ramen, baozi and jiaozi, green curry, pad thai, pork egg rolls, and gatiu, my favorite food in the whole world. While making these foreign foods, I became immersed in the languages and cultures of these foreign countries, as well as their art and literature. I actually wrote and fully illustrated a 200-page children's novel, and during this time, I found out about the Casiopea album, Makeup City. This album wasn't as life-changing as Everywhere at the End of Time, but it was certainly very inspiring, and it got me back into heavily practicing drums, and I started to learn guitar, which I soon realized was impossible to learn without learning piano first. This brought me into learning theory, chords, scales, modes, and I basically had to relearn everything since I was completely a drummer, and I didn't even know what notes were at the time. And just like Everywhere at the End of Time, this album kind of built my summer, and everything I did, I was always playing some of those tunes in the background, and it just made it a great summer. Later, I found some higher level doodles that I did during class, and I began doodling in class 7, a art project consisting of a massive collection of doodles, 15 times the size of the one you're looking at right now. The goal of this project was to be sort of a mental endurance test to see how much I could actually draw without running out of ideas. The whole thing was just a massive collection of doodles and stories, and some very detailed, some less detailed, but the whole thing all tied together with a big, massive story. And a deep overall message and social commentary, which you'll find out later. It's not even done yet. I'm still working on it. While working on this project, I discovered Vaporwave, an amazing kind of aesthetic form of nostalgic music, which inspired me to create my own, which you can find on this channel. By then, the weather had started to grow colder, so I've gotten a gigantic greenhouse to go over pretty much my entire Centropic tropical farm.
put a greenhouse in my backyard, my rainforest was complete.
And even with school starting, I was able to stay productive and keep working on my goals.
I began working on the third layer of human centropic systems, the project that I had started 7 months ago, inspired by Julie Moretti's Cairo, as well as the centropic farm I'd created in my backyard. The actual canvas work didn't take too much time, but planning how I was going to lay out the inking took most of the work, as well as waiting for materials to arrive by mail.
This piece is meant to represent the contrast between the human centropic system versus nature's centropic system, and how they coexist together and work against each other.
Each layer of the painting represents a level of the human centropic system as if it were a strata of the actual natural rainforest. In the last layer, the two systems combine in a chaos of black lines that merge together, creating the new system that we call the world.
Since the painting is on a recycled table rather than an actual canvas, it took a lot of work to hang up.
I began to get more into digital art, coloring one of the sections from doodling in class 7. And I created this digital portrait, which took me about 32 hours, and I'm proud to say I drew every line completely from scratch. While the finished product was incredibly rewarding, I will never do this again in my entire life. It was just such a grind. I got into Japanese city pop a lot while working on this project. I would just put on a long YouTube playlist and just work on this for 6 hours straight. It helped me learn Japanese and also helped me with my jazz funk groove. The next grind I did was photographing and photoshopping 130 plus pages of my Kabila graphic novel I wrote in middle school. I did this so that people on Instagram could read it in high quality print, since I only had one copy and it was written in pencil.
As you can imagine, this took a long time, and I used the time to immerse myself in Nujabi's music.
Finding Nujabi sent me to Samurai Champloo, which inspired me to start drawing my own anime and manga.
I am now on the path to being able to draw realistic human proportions so that I can create my own high-level manga, and I also am looking to sample some classical guitar so I can make my own hip-hop beats, just like Nujabi's. On top of all that productivity, I watched a lot of great films this year, thanks to my friend Elijah Vanderfluid, and here are some of the honorable mentions.
Eternal Sunshine of the Spotless Mind, Starship Troopers, Who Killed Captain Alex, Baraka and Samsara, Spirited Away, Ocean's 11, Fantastic Planet, Mad Max Fury Road, Snowpiercer, Your Name, The Raid Redemption, and Memento. Now, there's probably a bunch of stuff that I left out, but the point is, 2020 may have been probably the worst year ever, but I was still able to get a lot more done, and I'm sure there are plenty of people who were able to get many things done that they didn't have time for, and if you didn't, I hope you try and use the remainder of quarantine and get as much stuff as you can done, because when things go back, you know, we just will not have the time to focus on things like art and stuff unless you're an artist.
The point is, even though this is probably the worst year we'll ever have, it's been very useful to me, and I think it will be significant to the rest of my life.
Thank you, 2020, but I'm glad to be done with you.